It's the second shotgun final of the day, and I have to say the women went through a pretty dark weather. It was not a lot of sunshine, it was raining, and it totally looked completely different from what it is right now. And I think we're happy that this happened. It's 17 degrees Celsius, and now it's feeling a little bit more like it actually is. In the women's finals, it was pretty cold, and I guess, I mean, we're all hoping for the sun to kind of stick around for at least a little while. The athletes had qualification all day. They actually shoot five different... they shoot five different bunches of 25 targets, and then it's all combined in qualification, and it becomes what it is now. So, these are the men that we have in the trap final today at the ISSF World Cup for rifle and pistol and also shotgun in Cairo 2024. Second final of shotgun, fourth final of the day. Welcome, if you're just getting in. These are the six we're going to see in this final, and we're just gonna meet them now in the presentation before they step onto their stations. The five stations they have there, on each station the athletes shoot one shot. We're gonna get into the rules in a little bit, but first of all, let's meet the athletes. We'll go into depth on what they've accomplished during their careers a little bit later when we start with the 25 targets that go on first. But now we have Turkey, Italy, Spain and Finland here. 30-year-old Tolga Tuncer from Turkey will be firing on position with a beep number one, which is definitely preferable to have. Beep number two, 27-year-old from Italy, Diego Valeri. Spain's 40-year-old Alberto Fernandez. Been here for some time, shooting since 1998. Turkish and a very well-known 41-year-old, Oguzhan Tuzun. We've seen him many times. He's also shooting since 1998. Then Valerio Grassini from Italy, 31. And finally, the youngest of all, absolutely youngest of all, only 22. It is Juho Mäkelä from Finland. Mohammed Al-Fahad of Kuwait is going to be the jury in charge. Sir Samech Mohammed of Egypt will be the referee in charge. So hopefully everybody's ready to get into it as we're having a great day today now, at least. New thing in qualification. Many of the athletes tried out to be at the top six, but only these six made it to the final. Twenty-five targets are in front of them before the first elimination. So, the athletes are shooting 25 targets non-stop. And then the lowest ranking finalist is being eliminated. In case of a tie, the one with the lower beep number goes out. So it's definitely a disadvantage when it comes to heading out of the finals and being eliminated. But when it comes to the gold medal at the end. The beep number really doesn't matter at that point. Then it's just 10 targets and the decision until the very last target, until the very last moment. As we could see in the women's competition, it was a tough one right until the very, very end when Kazakhstani's Dmitrienko won the gold. We can see the coaches a little bit. There's been some red ones. The men haven't started as well as women did. I don't know what's happening. Maybe they're minding the wind as well. And just to add, there were 103 athletes that tried to get into this finals. These six made it in the end, and among these were some great athletes that we know, like Clement Bisagi, who's been awarded the Athlete of the Year of the ISSF. He's had 117 hits in the qualification. Josip Glasnevich, right above him there in the 15th place. Andreas Garcia, Matthew John Coward-Holy in the 25th place, David Kostelecki in the 27th place. So it was a true big competition over here. And as I mentioned, it wasn't an easy one with the weather. Now it's pretty okay, but surely they've had a bit of trouble in the qualification. As you can see, we're not seeing some of the big names that we're used to seeing in the finals. We're seeing other big names in the finals. Mikhailov started off 3 missed targets in a row. This is his coach, Pekka Maunula. Yeah, it's not like in the mixed team event where you can ask for a timeout. Anything you can do here too much, and it goes wrong, and you can just try and get back on the horse. Oguzhan Tuzun, 41-year-old from Turkey, has been to the Olympic Games since Athens in 2004. Actually, since Sydney in 2000. And his last Olympic Games were in London. So he's been around for quite some time, unlike Juho Mäkelä, who's won the bronze medal at the World Championship in Osijek 2 years ago as a junior. He was still a junior then. Yeah, that was probably his last year as a junior. And this is his second time in the World Cup, in a final of the World Cup. First time was in Baku 2 years ago when he finished 6th. And that was the only chance so far that he got to be in a final of a World Cup in the senior individual competition. Grassini, 31. Junior world champion back from 2009 in Maribor. He's won 2 World Cups, 1 mixed team, 1 individual. That was 10 years ago in Acapulco, the World Cup. Those were the standings. We're expecting things to change as we go on through the finals. It's only 5 targets so far. We need to come to 25 for the first elimination. too soon. Oh, that's gonna be a mess. Gassini. It's a hit. Yeah, the waves of wind are coming on as well in the men's event. Back to Tuncer. 30 years old. He missed the target now. It's not his first World Cup. He won a mixed team event. Silver medal in Almaty last year. And a bronze one in Baku 2 years ago. In Lonato, he was fifth in the World Cup. In the finals, also in Changwang back in 2019. So he's been in a couple, if not a few, of these World Cup finals. We'll see if he can fish himself out of this situation. Two missed targets in a row. He did that in the first round as well. Michale with a hit. Maybe he's coming back on the horse from qualification. That was pretty good. He ended up sixth above many of the big names in this sport. He had 119 hits in qualification. Oh. Let's see if there's another hit from the Finnish man. It's gonna be a missed target, and it was a right one, I think. That's a hit from Tuncer Valeri. Oh. 27. Not a lot of experience. Might be his debut in a final of the World Cup. So knowing that, he's standing pretty strongly and pretty firmly, doing a pretty good job. Grassini. He's been shooting since 2006. Back into a hit. It's not bad. Tuncer. 10th target. Again, a miss. He's hit only 5 targets so far out of 10. Valeri hits down the target. Only 1 miss so far. Fernandez. 40-year-old from Spain, Tokyo's mixed team event champion, 2-time world champion, World Cup final champion from New Delhi back in 2017. And I can't tell you how many World Cup medals this man has. So I'm not surprised that he is at the top of the rank there. He's won 8 World Cups. And, well, when it comes to World Cup medals, Fernandez has the most of them in gold shine. 5 silver medals and 4 bronze medals for the second placed right now. Alberto Fernandez. Valeria at the top, but they are kind of sharing the position as they both have 9 hits so far. They both missed the first target. Yes, that was just settling in, you know, and then continuing on into the final. Very strong and confident, focused, and that's great to be able to come away from a miss, not really think about it much. Few hits in a row. Grassini. That's going to be a first miss of this 5. And it continues on into the Finnish athlete, Mäkelä. It's a streak now. Now somebody needs to break this red streak. Valeri. He makes it. Doesn't let it go on. And continues to hold his place at the top of the rank with Fernandez. Too soon. Looked like a straight target. It's pretty low, but it was a hit. Grassini's on the first station. That was the right target, far right target, but he found it in the sky. Mäkelä, second station, shooting a left target, and he just kind of went ahead away from it. Unfortunately, none of it got to the target. The actual clay that breaks pretty easily. Oh. Station number 5 for Fernandez. It's a hit. Grassini. Another hit. Looked like a straight target, pretty low. That was a left target for Mäkelä, but now he caught it. Last station, he lost the target and he was ahead of it a bit, aiming ahead. Now he's in the center of the target. Shot it down. One by one, the targets are falling down. It's a good time to mention some athletes are actually shooting for ranking points only, or short. It's RPO, which means they don't really shoot to end up in the final of the competition, but they shoot to be ranked for the Olympic quota after the last ISSF World Cup in Munich. And if they're eligible, meaning if their country still has an empty quota place and if they're high enough on the rank, they can get the quota, and that's the last moment to get the quota over that ranking points that they've been kind of collecting throughout all of the World Cup finals, all of the World Cups that they were shooting in qualification and just appearing, you know, everywhere. So that's how it goes. We even had it today in the qualification. You can see it with a couple of athletes on the ISSF web, where the results are. Targets have passed, and 10 more targets are ahead. Tuncer and de Mechelen are tied at 9, but Tuncer is definitely in a better position here, as his beep number is number 1, which means in a case of a tie, he's safe. He stays in the game. Ten targets is enough targets for this whole situation to change, so I wouldn't want to comment on that just yet. We don't know if it's going to stay like this. Tuzun, Grassini are also here, kind of similar, and even maybe Valeri might be in the whole picture. Fernandez is kind of climbing away from the rest, and well, it's not a surprise. It's been 4 different Olympic games so far in his life. In Beijing, in London, then in Rio. And then finally, he got to Tokyo. He was 9th in the individual competition, but the mixed team event suited him just well, as he won the mixed team event gold medal of the Tokyo Olympics. Unfortunately for trap shooters, the trap mixed team event will be replaced with the skeet mixed team event now in this upcoming Olympics. So the skeet shooters get a little bit of a opportunity to try out the mixed team event at the Olympics. Let's see, Grassini shoots the target down. It was the fast one. Mechelen. Tuncer. Here's the ISSF president, Mr. Luciano Rossi. He's been to every final today, actually. And awarding the medals at the ceremonies. That's going to be 2 missed targets in a row from Fernandez and then Tuzun. Grassini breaking that streak of red into a green. Station number 3. Here is Mechelen. That was a right target. There's the chairman of the ISSF shotgun committee as well. Two times in a row for both Fernandez and Tuzun. Put them a little bit down, but I do have to admit that the light changed. The wind started off stronger. So all of these things get to you in the finals and in qualification as well, but especially in a nerve-wracking thing such as the finals. They really have to be able to combine accuracy and focus and these swift reactions that they have to find the targets, especially when the light is changing so much and the wind is blowing the targets away. In the past Olympic events, there was a popular variation of the trap men event. It was called double trap. And I guess as the event says for itself, instead of the targets flying out one by one, there are two released simultaneously from a different trap machines and varying angles and heights, just in, like in this one. But you should shoot two at a time, which is kind of similar to skeet. Let's see the standings after 20 targets. Valeri Fernandez up there, one hit of a difference. Then Tuzun and Grassini are tied at 14. Tanter and Mekale, one hit of a difference. Not sure it can all completely change, but definitely the ones who are one hit of a difference or tied, the next five shots could bring some clarity. The higher the big number, the better. If you get in a situation where you're tied, you're fine, at least for that moment. It's a green streak so far. Back to Tanchet. Last round before the elimination. That was a left one for Valeri Fernandez. Right target. Tuzun. On the last station, the right target got away. It was a high and a fast one. Mekale. Yeah, not me, he missed that target. Technical delegate, Mr. Bodo from Germany. He's taking care of the shotgun range from the beginning of this competition and even before the beginning of this competition. Everything needs to be in place and perfect. Precise, just like the sport asks for. Tuzun, that's a hit on the target. Grazzini. Yeah, it's getting more and more obvious that Mekale is the one who's in the red zone, who is currently the first one to maybe fall out, especially as his beat number is the furthest down as well. So there's not a lot of chance. Valeri. Valeri and Fernandez are kind of there side by side with Valeri in the lead. The 27-year-old doesn't have a medal to his name just yet, so that's interesting. This is his debut. Sometimes it might be easier coming in, you know, no pressure, the past. And it might just be a good day. Tuncer, 17 hits total after 25. That doesn't put him too high up in the ranking, but also somewhere in the middle, actually, as everybody else is still have one more target to shoot, so we can't really know yet where is he going to be placed. Valeri and Fernandez definitely at the top, definitely safe for the first elimination. And yeah, now we're coming to, you know, Mekale. Oh. And it's going to be the sixth place for the 22-year-old junior bronze medalist of the World Championship 2 years ago. Now he's fighting with the big boys here in the senior competition, big dogs. And he fell out six, but in the end, he did find himself in the final. And that's not a small thing for somebody coming out of the junior competition into the senior one. '22 for Valeri, '21 for Fernandez, Tuzun and Grassini with the Grazzini with 18 hits, and Tuncer is down with 17. That might still change between the two Turkish athletes and the Italian. Next five is in order, and well, the fifth place is to be decided, starting with Tuncer from his beep number one, as he was first after qualification. Only one miss in this round, that was Tuncer. Let's go back to him and see if he can come back from that miss. Yeah. Hits the target. Valeri. Station number three, and a left target, high left target for Valeri. Had him lose it. Fernandez. Susan. Another left target, but Tuzun finds it. Was an unfortunate one for Valeri. Vicini hits the right, far right target. Back to Tuncer. That was a lower right target there. Another lower right target, but Valeri now finds it. I don't know which one was more challenging for Valeri. Obviously, the left one that he had went a bit high. too soon. Went to the left. He found it very quickly. That was a swift reaction. Grazzini. That was a straight target for the Italian. And a miss. 31-year-old. Junior world champion. Oh. It's been 11 years for Grazzini, and since he won the last World Cup, at least in the individual competition. He did win a bronze 3 years ago in New Delhi. Yeah, he's approaching the, if not orange, if not red zone, then the orange zone. Somewhere over there with Tuzun and Altunzer on the far end, low down the rink. Now with that missed target, it's not going to be easy to stay in, no matter the beep number. Well, it's Tuzun is believing that this is a hit, and the referees, the side referees, decided that that it wasn't. He's pretty sure, but what can you do? Tolga Tuncer. He's going to take the fifth place. As I said, no matter the beep number, you have to have your kits as well to be able to stay in. The 30-year-old from Turkey. Sleep final in the fifth place right after Juho Makele won the sixth place. Now, four men are in the final. Two Italians, Fernandez from Spain and Tuzun from Turkey, so Turkey still has an opportunity for a place on the podium. After 30 targets, Valeri and Fernandez are tied. Grazzini, 22 hits, Tuzun, 21. It might be, the next one might be a battle. Between Tuzun and Grazzini. Grazzini. Was a far right target, but he found it. Oh. That's the first miss of this round from Fernandez. It's time for Tuzun. It's the target. So Fernandez fell to the second position, second place, and Valeri, who is a debuter, is taking over the lead. And taking over the lead, not from anybody, but from an Olympic champion. Oh. Not a small deal, it's a big deal for Valeria, I'm sure. He's only 27. And Fernandez has been in the game for more than 20 years, at least 25. Back to Valeri. That's gonna be his miss. It was on a left target. Fernandez, oh, he misses as well. But he's complaining, thinking that maybe it was a hit. Although the referees, the side referees that have the red flags do not agree. Tuzun hits the target, Grassini. Yeah, that was a red, that was a right target, and it was kind of in the height of highs. So it didn't fly too high. Maybe the nerves are coming in for Valeri. Missed the last two. He's tied with Fernandez. Tuzin hits his, and well, now it's the deciding one. The very much deciding one. That's going to be a miss, but Grassini, yeah, he was with a beep number five, so it wouldn't have been easy for him anyway. That hit from Tuzun definitely has Valerio Grassini out of the picture. Fourth place, not on the podium, unfortunately. The 31-year-old is going to have to leave the ISSF World Cup this time. He's had a good year in 2021, the same year when the Tokyo Olympics happened. So it might have been a possibility for him, but it's only the first World Cup, and there's still 6 more months to the Olympics. Valeri with a hit, Fernandez as well. They're still tied to Zun. He's not in a position to have space for missing the targets. It's happened though. 26 hits so far. He's falling behind the two top men, Valeri and Fernandez. It is what it is. It would need a miracle. It would take a miracle for Tuzun to climb up among Valeri and Fernandez now. But at least he knows he's got a place on the podium. That's for sure. Valeri hits the target. Oh. He's come back from that last round where he had 2 missed targets in a row. And this is now, yeah, with that one last miss, this is definitely a decided bronze medal for Oguzhan Tuzun. And the gold medal is going to be between Valeri and Fernandez. We're going to battle it out for the top place on the podium. 10 more targets. One last target before the bronze medal. That was a broken target. Fernandez shooting once again, and he shoots it down. Valeri and Fernandez both, like, nobody is letting it go. And with that last hit, going out with a bang, as I like to say. Ağuzun Tuzun from Turkey, 41-year-old, still going strong, pretty strong here at the ISSF World Cup for rifle, pistol, and shotgun of 2024. The season opener of the Olympic season. Bronze medalist, Ağuzun Tuzun of Turkey. Valeri and Fernandez. And 10 targets in front of them. Now, if they tie, it's going to be a shoot-off situation, which we didn't have so far because everything is decided on the beep number. But once we get to the last 10, the decision is only on hits or on missed starts. No one is pulling away. That's going to be a miss from Valeri, 27-year-old. Fernandez definitely has more experience and has been in high tense situations, high tense finals, more than Valeri. Looks like Fernandez is now holding that one difference of an advantage. And the sun is coming out for the last five targets. Seven. Another miss from Valeri. Looks like everything was fine until the battle started between the two. It's a duel now. Fernandez is feeling it as well. Back to the first station for Valeri. That was a high right target. Shoots it down, and Fernandez loses his target, meaning the last five might be the deciding one.
the gold medal.
Thirty-seven each. After 45 targets, we go up until 50. And these five targets will decide the winner unless they tie at the very, very last moment. And the very last target. Two hits. Again, nobody's pulling away. And the stakes are high. Would be a good way to start the Olympic year at the top of the podium, wouldn't it? Oh. 13 years of a difference between these two men. And not a single target of a difference as we're approaching the 50 targets. If it's not settled in this way, then it's a sudden death shoot off. That was a nice hit of a pretty high right target from Valeri. Fernandez finds his, and let's see the last one, the decision that the last target will bring. No place for an error. That's a miss for Valeri. And Fernandez hits the target. I'm pretty sure this is exactly what happened in the trap women event as well. So the last moment, it was almost that they're going into a shoot-off. And in the end, things turned around, and the women's event, it was Mitrienko, but now in the men's event, it's Alberto Fernandez from Spain winning the gold medal, and the 27-year-old, a young Italian, Diego Valeri, winning the silver medal. I don't think he's very, very happy with the last shot, and that one that went well, pretty straight, and he was sure that he hit that, but what can you do? That's how it happened at the very end. Stakes are high, and the tension is growing. Everybody has to be super, super focused onto it. ASTAF World Cup Cairo 2024, the opener of the season of the year where the Olympics will happen. Oguzhan Tuzun from Turkey with the bronze, Diego Valeri from Italy with the silver, and Alberto Fernandez from Spain with the gold. Thank you for watching. I hope you had a wonderful time with us. Tomorrow, we have two finals, and they're going to be 10-meter air rifles, so we're back in the final hole, and hopefully the shotgun athletes here will have a little bit more of sunny times here until we come back on the 30th for the final ski women and men event. My name is Martina Lucic, and well, I'll see you back tomorrow, 1:45 local time, for the final of the 10-meter air rifle men. Goodbye until then.